Turns out people lie every 10 minutes, but I don't. Hey everyone, I'm Trace, and you are not watching DNews. I swear everything from here forward will be true, no lies. Lying comes naturally to many types of animals. If you were designing a species, you might not make it possible for them to lie, but since we weren't designed, we evolved. It's all about competitive advantage. For example, if I'm a female nursery web spider, I want the best mate, and also the males would want the best mate too. But in nursery web spider society, the males have to bring a gift in order to mate. A study in BMC evolutionary biology found that the males usually wrap the gift, it's mostly dead insects, in silk so that the female doesn't know what is inside. Then, while the female checks out the gift, the male gets it on with her. Bow chicka wow, whoa, whoa! This gift is fake. That is right, some male spiders will actually bring fake gifts, and it does work. Of the spiders studied, 92% of the fake gift group still got to mate, although admittedly not for very long, since as soon as the female spider knew it was up, she scuttled away. A 2013 study in Proceedings of the Royal Society B says we humans lie for competitive advantage too. If I successfully deceive you, and thus you think we're working together, then I have a competitive advantage. Think about it this way. If you lie about cheating on your partner, you're still getting cooperation from him or her, thus competitive advantage. If you get a gift from grandma and you hate it but you pretend to like it, you've saved that relationship and you might get a better gift later. Competitive advantage. This ain't just humans either. In primate populations with high levels of cooperation, the researchers also find high levels of tactical deception. Basically, we could have evolved to lie simply to trick each other into cooperating. And this happens all the time. According to a 2002 study in basic and applied social psychology, people may lie as often as 2 or 3 times in a 10-minute conversation. Considering Americans spend an hour and 45 minutes per day every day just talking, that means we could be telling 30-some lies per day. Now, these aren't all huge lies, some are just little ones, I'm sure, though the researchers were actually moot on that. But one thing still holds us together, lies give us some kind of advantage. But even though lying is encouraged by evolution, there are consequences. According to a study in BJ Psychiatry, people have more deceitful personalities tend to have more white matter and less gray matter in their prefrontal cortex, the part of the brain associated with personality and moderation of social behavior. White matter connects parts of the brain together, so more white matter means more brain connections, but does that mean they're better at deception or that they have some advantage or a disadvantage? More research is needed. But lying as part of evolution, that is definitely a thing. By age 4, 90% of children have learned to lie, which might give you the sads, but it's actually a milestone in healthy development. In child psychology, there's something called the theory of mind, which is the idea that you are independent from others. You have your own beliefs, desires, understandings, etc. And a study in Psychological Science trained 3-year-olds on the theory of mind concept and found that they were then more likely to lie than kids who hadn't been trained. Walking that social tightrope of lying just enough, but not too much, that's tough. Lying all the time, sure, it probably can work, but never lying ever, not at all, not even once, also a great idea. And if you believe that, I am Iron Man. Are you worried that we are lying to you, that everyone is lying to you? I mean, maybe you should be. Tara has some tips here on how you could spot a liar.
Now, you've probably heard that liars tend to avoid eye contact, but did you know that dilated pupils can also be a sign? These are caused by increased tension and concentration, typically experienced when someone is lying. Defensiveness is another telling behavior that can manifest in multiple ways. If someone's voice suddenly gets higher, for example, that's a pretty good giveaway.
I lied to a cop once. I ran over a sign on school property when I slid off the road. I told him I didn't do it, and I got in big trouble with my parents, and I was grounded from the car for 2 weeks. But I was testing my evolutionary competitive advantage, right? What was the biggest lie you ever told? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe so you get more DNews, and thanks for watching.